Hi, Mr. Rabelais here again with a homework helper for Label, Label, Label. Now this is a strategy that I want the kids to use when they're working on a math problem, to use their pencil to actually get in there and to make marks, and don't worry about drawing on the problem. It's perfectly okay in the elementary grades for them to draw a picture, to label, to do skip marks on number lines or whatever it happens to be. Let me explain to the parents why this is. Because your elementary student really is still making that transition from what is real and what is make-believe. And in fancy educator language, we say what is concrete and what is abstract. They're moving from this problem on a paper, which really doesn't mean anything to them, and if they can touch it physically, and if they can mark it and they can label it, then it can kind of help make that problem come alive, and then they can go from the story or the word problem to a number sentence and then eventually some solution. Let me show you an example of how we want the kids to use their paper. Now, it might seem easy to you and I to say, hey, why do we have to teach kids to write there and to show their work? We used to call it showing their work. It's because you and I look at a problem and go, oh, I see the answer. I can derive that answer, you know, an abstract idea or theme in my mind. But the kids can't do that. Let me just show you real quick. Here's a problem that's on an average homework page that would go home with a kid, and here's one where they really have to use a strategy of labeling. Let me show you why. The problem says the graph shows the favorite drinks of the students in Mrs. Harwood's class. Then there's a chart here with the bar graph, and the question down here says, how many students choose a drink other than water? One of the things we ask the kids to do, part of our IPAC strategy, or our problem-solving strategy, go look at that homework helper, is to actually underline the question. And if they'll underline the question, picking out any important words, it really helps to make sure that they have read that. A lot of kids will look at the table and just start picking numbers and they get kind of confused. Get them to focus. Label, label, label. In fact, I tell the kids, label, 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 like my Aunt Mabel. And I really do have an Aunt Mabel. So what we want the kids to do with this is we want them to label each of these bar graphs so that they can go through. They need to physically touch it. It gives a little more time for their brain to process what's going on. So lemonade, it looks like it's between 2 and 4, and of course that would be 3, so they put a label up there. Milk, it looks like that's 4. Juice is between 4 and 6, and that's got to be 5. Soda is all the way up here at 10, and water is at 2. So now we have, now we're labeled. Now that gives us the information, we don't have to go back and look at it again. We'll ask the kids to double check their labeling to make sure that they're labeling correctly. But they can go back here and go, and how many students chose a drink other than water? So what they could do is they could, again, another strategy. They're writing right on the problem. They're writing and scratching that out. Now they can go and make a number sentence out of it. And they would say, okay, it's 10 plus 5 plus 4 plus 3. They get an answer, 22, whatever the answer even might be. But the important thing is that the kids need to label. They need to touch it. They need to feel it. That's why we still use manipulatives with kids in the fourth grade. And even into the fifth grade, using blocks, using strips, using pie charts that they can touch and hold, because they really need that physical connection with what they're reading. They're not quite ready to drift off into just reading a problem and understanding it. If you're helping your child do their homework, make them label. Label, 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 like my Aunt Mabel. This is Homework Helper.